Hi, I'm Mark Stelly with the League City Building Department. I also happen to be a backyard enthusiast for going green. Hold on a second. These girls are arguing about who gets to water the garden.
Girls. I know that last time one of y'all watered and the other one didn't get to, but y'all have to come up with a set of rules.
I want to go green first. Well, just because she's older doesn't mean she has to go green first.
Okay, well, come over here and let's talk to the camera just a little bit, and we're going to make a video about us going green in our backyard. These are my two daughters, Emily and Elizabeth. Today we're here to talk about our rain collection system. What we've done is buried in the ground basically a cistern here that holds 550 gallons, and then behind me is another cistern that holds approximately 700 gallons of water. The water comes from the roof system. Whenever it rains, we have tied all the gutters on the back of the house together, and they all come down through the yard and they enter into this one, and then when this container fills up, it overflows into the other container. As you can see, it's almost full. We had a little bit of rain over the weekend, but we've also been pumping down out of this container. This one over here is a little bit more full. This one from the surface water level is about 8 feet deep, so it goes pretty deep into the ground, and that's why it holds almost 750 gallons of water. What we actually have here on the ground where the hose is coming out and the electrical cord is going in is a portal just to access our water until we can get the pumps installed and working properly. That hopes to be the final stage of this project, where we put some solar panels on the roof and use them to actually pump the water out and water the garden. And out of this container over here, we hope to, or are planning to use it to flush the toilets that are in the house as another way of saving green. We didn't want to just use regular electricity, because then that wouldn't have been going green if I'm doing all of this. We wanted to do something that would help by not being a tax on the electrical system as well. We're going to talk a little bit about why I chose to go with such large rain containers. Whenever I first started this, I had two 65-gallon food quality containers, and I started filling one of them up in a small rain. Well, at the time that happened, the rain shower only lasted about 20 minutes, but during that time, I filled up three different containers in just a 20-minute rain that was only about a quarter of an inch. At that time, I realized that I didn't have enough storage capacity, so I went out and got one more bigger barrel, and that's why we ended up with almost 1,300 gallons of rain storage. I'm going to let Elizabeth and Emily talk about the vegetable garden now.
Hi, if you'd follow me over here to the vegetable garden. We've been growing many herbs and spices and vegetables and fruits. My personal favorite is the cilantro, because you can just pick it and eat it. And we're growing really big tomatoes, and Emily wants to talk to you about some stuff too.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Okay, over here, these little plants, we have strawberries, and right now we're growing one big strawberry, and it's very red, and we're very proud of it. This plant right here is a blackberry plant. It's got lots of blooms on it, so hopefully soon it will have lots of blackberries. Me and Emily share the watering duties for the garden, and all we have to do is plug the pump into that yellow extension cord, and then you take it, because the hose is connected to the pump inside the water barrel, and then you water it.
To do a project like this, you do need to get a building permit. It's an easy process. I think you'll find that the building department has gotten real customer friendly these days. We really want y'all to come see us, see if we can help y'all with something. I want to thank all of y'all for watching this video. This has been quite a nice project for the family. They helped us actually keep the yard clean while the big barrels were going in the ground. They did a lot of work with us on the flagstone work that we've put down, and they were instrumental whenever we were putting the vegetable garden in. And as you see, they both have a job to water it, and soon we hope to be pulling the fruit out of our labors from the vegetable garden. It's been a lot of fun. We hope to see y'all real soon on Going Green with League City. I'm Mark Stelly.
I'm Elizabeth Stelly.
And I'm Emily Stelly.
Thanks for watching.
See you next time on Building Green with the Stelly Household. Woo!